Assalamu alaikum guys, welcome again to my YouTube channel, here Muhammad Imran. Today we are learning a new tutorial related to for loop. For loop is very unique and basic concept in every type of programming language. So we are just working on C#, so we will discuss for loop in C#. So I have just spoken on my presentation. So as we are discussing about C# for loop, so first of all I have just prepared some bullets, so just follow the things which I am going to explain in front of you. So first of all, the main thing is that the for keyword, we have to use for keyword which indicates a loop in C#. Okay, so if you want to use for loop, then you have to use the keyword for. Okay, and we will discuss it later with the implementation in C#. So next one is the for loop executes a block of statements repeatedly until the specified condition returns false. Okay, have you understand this? The for loop will execute until the condition will be false, otherwise it will be executed again and again. Okay, and we are just coming to the syntax. So this is the syntax. First of all, as we have discussed that for keyword is used, for, then brackets, then we have to mention here the variable name, either int type, float type or something else. If we are just declare the variable and we have just given the value to the variable, then it will be called initialization. You can also declare variable outside the for loop. If you are give value at the time of declaration inside the for loop, then it will be initialization. So first of all, variable initialization, then when it will be initialized, then it goes to the second step, condition. When the condition will be true, it will give you the input, otherwise it increment or decrement. And then this is the statement, this is the code which is just inside the for loop. If the condition will true, this statement will be done. Okay, we will discuss it with the implementation. So just let's go to the Visual Studio. Now open your Visual Studio to check that how to implement for loop in the C#. So we are just sharing for loop example. So first of all, we discuss that for keyword. Okay, then here we have to declare or int i variable. This is the int type and this is variable name i. If you want to give value, then it will be converted from declaration to initialization. So this is initialization, and then we have to give condition according to the syntax which we have discussed before. And here I am just going to give value 10, and here semicolon to terminate the condition, and i++ as decrement or increment. I am just doing here increment. So then bracket close, here curly braces, then we are going to output the statement console.readline value of i placeholder 0 and then comma and i and then close. Okay, we have to write it here. Okay, so this is the code, and this is the very easy code for my beginners for watching my videos regularly. So first of all, we declare we have mentioned a for keyword, then we have initialized the value to 0, then this is the condition, and this is the increment or decrement, and this is our statement. So let's start to run this code. You can do it by pressing this button, this icon green, and having name start, or you can also press Control F5. So I'm just clicking here, then black screen has been appeared in front of you. So first of all, this is the file, this is the output. So for int I is equal to 0, first it comes here, I values is 0, then it will go here to check the condition, I is 0, of course 0 is less than 10, then this condition is true. Okay, when this condition will be true, it comes here, not go there. So third step is console.writeline means statement within the for loop. So then it will execute this file. So value of i, this is the placeholder, and I value still is 0, so this is 0. Then it will comes here, this is the fourth step. Okay, then I plus plan plus plus plus, so I was 0, then 0 plus 1 is 1. So when this condition, when this condition will run, then automatically it comes to condition. So I now 1 is less than 10, so condition is again true, and then it comes here, then it 1, then it will 2, then 3, then 4, then 5, then 6, then 7, then 8, then 9. When 9 will be displayed, then it comes again here. Okay, then 9 plus 1 is equal to 10. So it now it will goes to condition, then I is 10 is less than 10. So 10 is less than 10. This condition is false because 10 is equal to 10. So this statement will not run. This will not execute this block. And this is easy tutorial. This is very basic concept of for loop. So if you want to, I have also prepared a diagram for all of you here. Okay, so first of all, as we check, this is the code, and here you can see that for int I is equal to 0, first this step will run in for loop. Int I is equal to 0, this is the initialization, then it will comes here, it check the condition. When the condition will true, it execute the statement. Okay, if not, then the screen will be display no result. Okay, then when this statement will run, then it will goes to here to increase the I. Okay, when it increase the I, then automatically it again go to condition. So first of all, initialize, then check the condition, then execute the statement, then increase the I, then after then 5 values it will check the condition. So then it will show you the output. So as I have give you an output, and this is very easy tutorial for all of you, and thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Okay, have a good day.